Okay, my name is Laura and I'm chatting with Chrissy, and we just wanted to give you guys an update on what's been happening so far and the transitions we've made and what the future might look like. So it's hard to believe we're already in week 6 of modified services. Families have been so flexible and accommodating, and the team's really been working hard to make sure services continue and kids get the least amount of disruption as possible and continue to learn. What sort of changes to programming have we had so far?
Yeah, we've had a lot. So the team had moved really quickly to move kids into home-based services, just to make sure that we had everyone as safe as possible. And then telehealth services started, remote group parent training has been added. We're hoping to continue to add on remote speech and OT services too. So there's been quite a few changes since this all started.
Yeah, it sounds like a few new pieces of the program have come in and it's still evolving and there's still more to come and more to be offered. With this transition, what do you think the strengths of the program have been?
Yeah, I think families' flexibility has just been really helpful. Everyone's been really understanding and cooperative to help us make all these changes in a very, very quick time frame. Everyone's ongoing communication, and then the team did just a really wonderful job getting everyone together and moving so quickly and making changes to the way that they work to make sure that we could continue all of our services for our clients.
Sounds like everyone's really working together to keep things moving for the kids and just give the best services possible. So while everything's gone so well before, I'm sure everyone's wondering what the future might look like. Can you speak a little bit about that?
Yeah, so I think that's a question everyone is wondering at the moment, and I don't think we have a really clear answer around that. There's a lot of uncertainty still. You know, our best guess is that there's not going to be a sudden, like, flip of a switch or a green light for everyone to move back into the center, and we'll have to continue doing some modified services and home services until there's a point where we know we'll be able to go back to normal. Keeping all of that in mind, there's not going to be this date that we could say everyone's going into the center at once. We're going to have to make a modified plan where we just phase everyone into the center and continue the current set of services, add maybe some more home services on for families who weren't getting any services before once they feel comfortable, and just slowly phase everyone back into the center.
That makes sense. So it's not necessarily one date where everything will transition back. It'll be a series of steps and also might look different for every family or every individual based on their needs and the area. That makes sense. So it sounds like for this plan, you guys are really thinking about safety and also just keeping the progress and momentum going. As far as safety goes and changes to what things might look like, what sort of procedures might be part of this plan? What changes might we see?
Yeah, so we've been kind of following what the guidelines have been out there and best practices are to make sure that we can keep everybody healthy and safe, but still be able to provide services to all the kiddos that we serve. So one of the things that we've been thinking about, or a few of the things that we've been thinking about as we start to shift back into the center, are just real strict safety measures. So only limiting the number of people in the center. So we might only start out with one or two clients in the center, and they're in different areas so that we can make sure that we're ensuring that there's distancing. Then increasing the number of people in the center as time goes on, instituting checklists for health and wellness, and making sure that there is really strict cleaning and sanitation procedures, restricting the items that are allowed in the center, and making sure that we're not bringing in anything from the outside, having new drop-off and pickup procedures that would also limit the amount of people coming in and out of the center. And then more strict procedures regarding illness for both our team members and our families, just to make sure that we don't have anyone coming in the center who could have any type of illness that they could pass on to everyone else. I think this is just a brief part of the plan. We are working to put together a really detailed plan that we can share with everyone once we have it.
Yeah, it sounds like you guys are really making things very thorough and probably collaborating with quite a few people to get all the boxes checked and keep everyone safe. Again, this is in the future that this will be rolling out and to be built, but in the meantime, we're continuing to take things day by day. Anything families should keep in mind right now, or?
I think just that continued flexibility and patience with us as we work towards plans to get things back to, a new normal for everybody. We want to make sure that we're keeping everyone's health and safety in mind. And patience is the number one thing. And in communication, it's important that whenever families have questions, that they can reach out and ask them, and they can reach out to their, OM or ACL or their BCBA or even myself, and we can just talk through any of their questions or concerns and make sure that everyone has all of the most up-to-date information.
That's great. I'll make sure and tag that contact information in the bottom of this message so everyone has it. And thanks again for taking a moment to chat this morning and get everyone caught up on what things look like now and what they might look like in the future.
Yeah, thank you.